Hi students, welcome to the next topic in the database management system, that is PL by SQL concept. So far we have discussed about the structured query languages and the different commands that are used in the structured query language. Now let us see what is this PL by SQL. So actually this PL by SQL is PL is a procedural language, structured query language. So it is a procedural extension language. So you call it as a procedural extension language for SQL. So for structured query language, you can call it as a procedural extension language. And for Oracle relational database. So this Oracle is mainly used this PL by SQL concept. So it is a procedural extension language for SQL and Oracle relational database. So it provides a built-in interpreted and OS independent programming environment. So it is completely independent of OS environment. Apart from Oracle, it also available in Times 10 in memory database and IBM database. So this PL by SQL will used in Oracle Times 10 in memory database and IBM database. Okay, so later. Actually, the syntax of this PL by SQL is based on ADA and Pascal programming languages. So completely depends upon the Pascal programming languages. Means it's just like ADA and Pascal programming language. Let us see the features of PL by SQL. So mainly the PL by SQL is tightly integrated with structured query language. So it is integrated with the structured query language, and also this PL by SQL offers extensive error checking. So it offers extensive error checking and numerous data types, and variety of programming structures. So this PL by SQL offers extensive error checking, numerous data types and variety of programming structures. And also it supports. So the PL by SQL supports structural programming through functions. Procedures and object-oriented programming. And development of web applications and server pages. So these are the services that supports this PL SQL is supported in structured programming languages. So whenever you are using the functions so with the help of the functions, you can use PL by SQL in structured programming as well as the procedures and an object-oriented programming. And also it helpful in it can also supports the development of web applications and server pages. Now let us see the block structure of the PL by SQL. The block structure indicates means how the procedure, the procedural language will be implemented. So what is the structure of that? So first will be the block header will be there. So block header, and you are having the declaration. Declaration header and execution section, and also having the exception section. So exception section is whenever the exception is raised, then only this section will be included, added. So this is an optional. So after the block header, you have to write as declaration header. So after declaration, you have to begin the program. So in the after written the begin, you have to write the execution section. So next is the exception. Finally, end. So this is the structure of the PL by SQL. So the program will be written like this. So here everything is required, means here begin, exception, end, this execution section, declaration section. So whenever the exception is occurred, then this section will be required. So the block header, whenever it is required. So these are all required in the program. So now let us see what is this block header will holds, what we write here. So this block header defines type of block, means what type of blocks you are using, like if you are using the procedures or functions, so like that. And the way it is called, and the way it is called, that will be written in the block header. Then what is written in the declaration header? So in this section, you will declare any variable. So whatever the variable that you want to use in the program, that variables will be declared in the declaration section. Declare any variable used in the block. Next, what about the execution section? So the execution section use variables and other PL by SQL objects to perform action. So complete action of the program will be done in the execution section. So this execution section will use the variables that are declared in the declaration section and other PL by SQL objects to perform specific action. After that, exception. So the exception section will handle any problem that occur in the program. Handle any problem that arises during execution of block. Okay, so these are the different header sections and the blocks that are used in the PL by SQL structure. So block header, declaration header, execution section, exception section. So this all will be declared with as, begin, exception, and end. So the important things here you have to be noted while you are writing the program. The points you have to note that. So one thing is PL by SQL is not a case sensitive. So you can write the program, you can write the characters or the strings, anything in the uppercase or lowercase. So it is not a case sensitive. And it uses same data type as SQL. Use same data type as structured query language. And the comments are represented in PL by SQL like This is a comment for multi-line and the two dashes will for single line. So this is a single line comment and this is a multi-line comment. Next, PL by SQL uses colon equal to is for assignment operation. This is an assignment operation, and semicolon for to indicate end of line. Okay, so these are the points you have to remember while you are writing the program. So one thing, the first PL by SQL is not a case sensitive. You can write it in upper letter, upper case or the lower case. So you can use same data types whatever you used in the structured query language. If you want to represent the comments, this is for multi-line and this is for single line. And this operator is used for the assignment, and for every statement, if it is the end of this line, you just indicate with the semicolon. Okay, so this is the concept of the PL by SQL. In the next video, I'll explain a simple program of PL by SQL. Thank you.